I've been thinking about this, and I guess the part that art plays in my life, and I had forgotten, but I realized that I started into it really early because the first thing I did was ask my parents for a paint-by-number set, probably when I was 9 or 10 years old. And but I also remember that I never ever finished it, and was still looking at it, I think, when I was 14, and I realized what I didn't like about paint-by-number sets is that I thought it's never going to look like something that you'd hang on the wall, because it's all these little spots with edges. And I didn't want a picture that looked like that. And that's part of my process now, even, is the combination of wishy-washy, vague watercolory backgrounds and then a foreground that's very precise with edges. In science courses and finding them way too heavy, and saw a sign, this is at Queen's University, outside the art gallery for drawing and sketching and painting classes, and I went straight in because I really needed the break, and was ready to sign up for oil painting classes, and they said you have to do drawing and ink work, pen and ink work first, and which I wasn't too happy about, but I fell into it in a big way and did pen and ink work for all the way up until I did the sketches of the church, which were about 10 years ago. I got very deeply into doing pen and ink sketches of old homes in central Ontario. And it was a great way to meet people, going to art festivals and getting commissions and driving up back roads and long driveways to look at old farmhouses and so on. And it was a great way to spend summers. After I got my degree in social work, I realized that I wanted something else again. I wanted to do something else with my life in terms of an artistic involvement. No, actually, it was a church involvement. And so I went looking at churches and really fell into the United Church, which had a teen coffee house, and they were looking for people like me that were in their early mid-20s to act as mentors, supervisors of the Saturday night coffee houses. And I, at that point, I'd started looking at all the art that is for rock concerts and so on. That one of the specialties they did was that they put on rock concerts because they had a big dance hall attached to the coffee house. And so I brought in my poster making kit, which was a great big board. We used to have a great time on Sunday afternoons turning out the posters for the next Saturday event. And so I got into doing this kind of work, which was I picked up from the magazines that were coming out of San Francisco during the era of peace and love and brotherhood. And this was for one of the rock concerts at the Way In Presents, which was at the St. Paul's United Church in their basement. And that says, Whiskey Howl. January 31st, down here, the Way In Coffee House in Orillia.
Beautiful.
Imagine for rock concerts in those days, the price was $1.50. In Ontario, I was always doing pen and ink work and watercolors, so I was always into the pastel-y world, I'll call it. And what the West Coast did to me was very strongly in terms of walking into the woods, was the deepness, the depth of it, the darkness and the greens. And it was very dramatic on my psyche, I'm going to say, because I looked around and I... And also the second thing which artists always look at is the light and the shadow and how the sun shines through, how the light comes through the trees and touches the ground and touches leaves on the ground and so on and so forth, and how it will highlight certain colors here and there. And I had heard there was a really good teacher at the Camosun College, and she was Czech trained, and she was quite wonderful. We all loved her. And she gave me the basic training, which was to lay out the painting with acrylics first, because they dry very, very quickly. In terms of all the dark tones, which so the trees would be a chocolate brown or a black, and the greenery would be the darkest tone of greens, and the sky at the top. And I'm very aware of the healing nature of painting, and I'm also aware of the healing nature of music. I mean, the other half of my looking after my soul and my psyche was when I quit singing in choirs for about 7 years, 8 years. When I moved out here when I was 40, I realized that I needed the connection with music, and I also realized I needed the connection with the church, that I needed to find a community, that I have a real sense that everybody needs a community of some sort that they're connected to. I always work from photographs, because I discovered that I couldn't work in the real light because it changes all the time, that you'd paint a certain kind of painting for an hour and then discover that a whole bunch of trees over there had were glowing yellow or something like that, so you'd paint them all in and then it became totally a hodgepodge. So and I always used to love working in watercolors because it's so wild and unpredictable. Again, the course that I took way back in my first year of university was to throw water on the canvas. And so you have puddles of water and then starting infusing the dots where the water is with color. And so that's my first painting that I do. The first level of painting is just to put greens and browns and blues and so on and watch what they do and stand there with a Kleenex so that I'm or a paper towel and going to quit it from running all over the place so it becomes defined in some ways, so you end up at after that technique, actually, with edges and with spots that will suggest greenery, just the edges of bushes, for instance, the edges of pine needles and so on and so forth. And so the rest of the process after that is to take a look at it and see what emerges. For me, another issue that has been part of my life was having an auto accident when I was 22 years old, which gave me a considerable back injury. And I realized in my 30s that that I'm going to say doing responsible things like going to work and working with people and making decisions along with people and so on could increase pain. And I also discovered that when I did things like music or art, I could eliminate pain or really reduce it to a great extent. Certainly when I came out here, as I say, and was so struck by, I mean, it's the landscape is so dramatic that you have to do something about it. It's my own sense. And I realized that when I paint, there's a shift in my brain, certainly to the other side of the brain, where, and my understanding is that I get away from judgment when I shift from the one side of the brain to the other side of the brain. And so when I'm painting, say for an afternoon, it's just a real upper. There's a terrific upper from producing something. On one level, you're producing something and being productive. But on the other is this issue of how one uses judgment and how one uses perception and awareness. So painting really takes me into looking at the world, and it really takes me at looking at the issues of light and shadow. It takes me into the issue of using a camera all the time, which and all that kind of just exploring the world and using one's awareness, to me, is really at the center of having a sacred life, having a connection to the sacred, is letting go of judgment and judgmentalism about good or bad, and shifting over into a place where it's a connection with myself and with a piece of myself that I think of as my spiritual self. It could even be at the level of being productive. And certainly that's my experience now during the COVID shutdown, is that I realized after about 5 or 6 weeks of isolation, I realized, first of all, that I was getting depressed. And so I needed to do something about that. But I also, so I pulled out my paints and started to, I thought, I'm going to paint like I never have before. I've always wanted this opportunity, and here it is. And I'd been told when I went to a gallery that I needed to come in and I needed to produce at least 25 to 30 paintings if I wanted to have a serious show. So I was probably up to that point, I had about 15. This is, as I say, 18 months ago, and I thought, okay, it's time to really get that bunch together. And so I found just the productivity as much as anything else, that I realized at that point, I think I need to feel productive at the end of the day, that it's very much a part of our mental wellness to feel we've accomplished something at the end of the day.